And the next speaker is Maria Lapik from Keldysh Institute, and she will talk about asymptotic of orthogonal measure for special polynomials in the problem of Raman-Sketchwin. Please, Maria.
Thanks to organizers for an invitation. This is a joint work with Alexander Aptekarev and Yuri Orlov. I would like to start with a simple case of two particles in quantum optics equation. This Hamiltonian describes this process. When one directs the light of frequency omega zero on the crystal grid, here we have some excitation, and emission of photons of the another with another frequency. And in more general case, which we will describe, we also have a lot of frequencies, omega 1 and omega p. The Hamiltonian is right in the form of operator of creation and annihilation, which defined here. Oops. And zero and one is a standard basis in the Fock space. It means that we have n zero particles in the state zero and n one particle in the state one. The operator of creation acts on this basis by this way. We have one more particles of the state zero and one n particles in the second state. We define the number of particles, operator of the number of particles by the formula. And in using this definition, it's easy to check that we have such properties. I would like to solve the problem by the two ways. By diagonalization by the Bogoliubov transformation, it's a classical approach, and by the approach which based on asymptotics of some polynomials. Bogoliubov transformation here has very simple view, and after that we have Hamiltonian in that diagonal form, and this is the Hamiltonian of two-dimensional harmonic oscillator with separate variables. the eigenvalues of this operator, of these operators are non-negative integers, and eigenfunctions of these Hamiltonians should be Hermite. This system has the conservation law, which is n0 plus n1 equal to n big. And the eigenvalues for this operator have this form. We represent the eigenfunction of Hamiltonian by resolution into four bases. Here we used the conservation law. Then eigenvalue problem can be write in this form. And after using the definition of creation operators, we will got the matrix form. Our goal is to got the limit distribution of energy levels and these coefficients. Let's define matrix D wave and D wave from recurrence coefficients and I want to defines some special polynomials for this problem. The problem of determining the distributions of eigenvalues of Hamiltonian for large occupation numbers when n tends to zero thus reduced to determining an asymptotic form of the spectrum of the matrix D. The vector nu zero, nu n depends polynomially on lambda. And we define polynomials P wave Qn by this formula. We remember that state nu zero not equal to zero, and we could make this definition. And also we have initial condition for polynomials. Everybody can recognize that here we have Kravchuk polynomials up to linear change of variables after simple shift. For Kravchuk polynomials, we know everything by the work of Peter Dragnev and Edward Saab. In that case, we have Kravchuk polynomials with parameter 0.5 up to linear change of variables. Our goal is to get asymptotic behavior of eigenvalues and eigenfunctions of Hamiltonian. For fixed n, the polynomial are orthogonal with respect to discrete measure with the support on the zeros of the last polynomial. It's the polynomial of degree n big plus 1. After scaling, we can write asymptotics of these polynomials in terms of some constraint logarithmic Pavlovian problem. In the case of Kravchuk, it's our simplest, the simplest case. We have the constraint measure equal to 0.5, and asymptotic behavior of the measures weight will be exponent of minus 2q, where q is the external field for this constraint problem. It's we know it from this work of Dragnev and Saab. Now we should consider the general case when we have p plus 1 sort of particles. Like in the previous case, we have this eigenfunction and eigenvalue problem. We defined the matrix D-wave. It has more complicated view, but we know everything here. And now we should like the, we should investigate the asymptotics. After scaling this matrix D wave, we got new eigenvalues and new polynomials. And coefficients are here. The eigenvalues these polynomials for each fixed n, the polynomials are orthogonal with respect to some measure which lies in the roots of the last polynomial, which I wrote here. We know from the view of from the construction of our coefficients that there are continuous limits of coefficients of the recurrence relations. So we have functions plus plus square root of q minus 2 square root of q here. And for such n, we can cut this length into n big parts, and after that we will get the new coefficients by our formulas. And also we can define alpha and beta by this expression, where C defined here and Q defined here. And this interval will play a role of an interval of equilibrium in constraint logarithmic potential problem, which describes our zero distributions. Also, we will define the zero counting measure by ordinary way. And after that, we have the next theorem. The zero counting measure has weak limit, and using Buyarov, Quillis, Rachmaninoff formulas, we have integral representation for the density of the measure. We use here the interval alpha beta, and this is the Chebyshev measure of this interval, and we have a logarithmic representation of the density. It's easy to check that if p is equal to 1, we have constant 0.2. 0.5, and for p greater than zero, it's impossible to get the explicit formulas, but we can compute this expression. It looks like this. I will write. For p equal to 1, we have constant, and it will be the constraint for our problem. And if p equal to, for example, 2, we have measure which behaves like this. And when p grows, we can see that the constraint behaves by this way. So we have big number of energy in this point, in the central point. And the question natural question, what we have when we consider the not scaling eigenvalues. So we have the proposition: the density limit measure after extension has this behavior. So if we return to lambda wave, we have such expression. Difference between two eigenvalue in the central eigenvalue equal to square root of n large, and it's square root of n large, it's for p equal to 2, and for and for p equal to, we have that this difference behaves like n. So we have new explosion and new concentration of energy in this point. I think it's why I have sometimes.
Yes, if you need.
Okay, I told before it's possible to get the density of the measure here, but we have not explicit. We have only condition theories. We should climb the Rahman separate conditions in existence of some limits.
Thank you very much, Maria. Let's send the speaker. Any questions? Mikhail Tilov.
Masha, could you please show your photon reconciliations with P? So you have reconciliation for Kravchuk and with P. And do you have exact formula for this lambda wave and this omega? I mean,
yes, what here?
And what is your small omega k and b? Omega
which omega?
Yeah, this one, but this number is not there. Yeah.
It's the initial frequency.
So it's some specific numbers or?
Yes, it's numbers from the Hamiltonian.
But do you find them or just you fix them from the very beginning?
No, it's we consider the Hamiltonian. It's our initial task, and we should investigate the eigenvalues of
the given one is what is B and E are also given or not?
So which?
Also B? E energy, right? It's energy.
Yes.
Is it?
Yes, it's energy which I wrote.
I mean, it's also given.
No, it's not given, but we can. This energy is the state level of this function.
Okay.
No, sometimes it's possible to calculate it. For Kravchuk, it's very simple for our first simplest case.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. More question? Andrei Gudrov.
Did you have in mind some physical applications? Because it looks like that. And some lasers or something.
Yes, I think this problem comes from some quantum optical. So it's lasers of frequency omega zero. Which light on the crystal grate and it's called the combination scattering. So after excitation in this point, we have different light. In classical optics, we have the same light. And here we have another effect.
Okay, thank you. Online questions?
Yeah,
if there is no question, let's thank the speaker again.